Good morning, dear students. Today let's start with the sociology part of social science, that is chapter 1, introduction of sociology. Introduction of sociology. What are we going to learn in this lesson? What are the objectives of this lesson? Let's discuss now. Okay. So the objectives and the things what we are going to learn today is origin, meaning, nature, scope and importance of sociology. What are we going to learn? Origin, meaning, nature. Origin means from where did it originate, where did it come from. The concept sociology, where did it originate. Meaning of sociology. Nature of sociology, scope and importance. What are the importance of sociology? We are going to discuss today. Then, what are the relationships? Relationships between sociology and other social sciences. In social science, you have different parts, isn't it? What we have discussed in the previous classes, like political science, sociology is also one part. Then what do we have? Geography we have. Then we have different parts like civics and history. We have different parts of social sciences, isn't it? But how is the relationship between sociology and other social sciences and interrelationships between them? We are going to discuss today. Okay, let's go through what is sociology. First, before that, human beings tries to understand the environment, nature and society from many years. What does that mean? As we had discussed in the first chapter, these prehistoric people, they used to live in forest, isn't it? They used to live in forest. They did not know the value of building a house. They did not know the talent of building a house. They did not know to build a house. So how were they influenced by this? How did they get idea? Because they studied the environment. As they used to live in forest, they used to sleep there. What happened? They were scared of danger of wild animals could eat them. So they learned the environment and they started living in caves. Where did they live? They started living in caves. And then even then there was kind of fear of animals eating them. They started putting fire in front of the caves. Same way they learned the environment part by part and then they facilitated themselves by building hut, then learning more and more regarding houses. They learned how to build the houses. What does that mean? Human beings are creative enough to understand the environment, nature and society around them. Understand? The people who used to live in rural areas, villages, when they come to city, start living there for years, they get influenced by the people who are living there. They can't continue their, rural area lifestyle, village lifestyle. They can't continue here. They will have one or the other changes in their lifestyle looking at the city life, isn't it? So we have capacity to understand the environment and mold ourselves. Next point. Humans are different from other animals and are intellectual beings. That means we have capacity to think, to understand. And we have capacity to think and decide something. For example, now you are walking in a lane, a plain lane, and there is a stone, a big rock stone you have in between the road. You are walking there. Animal would just go and jump on that and just move friend. Being a human being, if you are going only today, what you will do? You will just cross that rock and you will go. But if you have to cross this lane daily, what will you think? It's just a small stone, I'll keep it aside and then move. So that it doesn't bother anybody or doesn't disturb anybody. So we have intellectual thinking, or we are intellectual beings who have capacity to think. Next point. There are many differences between animals and human beings. As we all know, animals don't have thinking capacity like us. They are animals, they live, they walk like us, they walk, they move, they live like us. But there is kind of difference between animals and human beings. Animals are not called intellectual beings, as I have given you an example. What are the differences? Let's discuss now. For example, body structure. We stand straight, isn't it? But animals, some animals try to stand, but they are not as straight as us, isn't it? Like monkeys, they start, they know they know to as straight as human beings. So body structure, there are much differences. Some have legs, some do not have legs, like reptiles, snakes. Do they have legs? No. The body structure is different of animals and human beings. Next, rate of growth. For example, a dog, it grows within a year, but humans take minimum 12 to 15 years to grow. Within 1 year, a human cannot grow. So what happens? The time gap of growing, it has to be dependent on the elders of the family, isn't it? So the rate of growth is different between the animal and human being. Next, food consumption. Animals can live anywhere. Animals can eat anything. We have only specific things. We cook the food and eat. We don't eat raw meat. Do we eat raw meat? No, right? We cook the food and we eat. We cook vegetables, we cook meat, we cook fish and then eat. So food consumption differentiates between animals and human beings. Next, creativity. As I've given you example over here, we are intellectual beings. We have thinking capacity to observe and decide something, isn't it? We have capacity to be creative. We can observe things. If something is wrong, we can think and we can judge it. Why is it wrong? Can we come over the problem? We have capacity to think, observe and decide. Humans are social beings. Humans are social beings. What does that mean? Let's learn now. There is no society without an individual. There is no society without an individual. We can't call a society as a society without people in it, isn't it? So when there are two or more number of people in some activity, we can call them as a society. They are living together. This is a society we can call. Then there is no individual without a society. One individual, one person cannot live alone throughout his life. He needs somebody to talk to. He needs somebody to share with. He needs some entertainment, isn't it? You cannot say that you are in society when you are daily meeting somebody. Just because you are meeting somebody, that doesn't mean you are in society. Even if you do not meet people, you are in society, you are part of society. For example, somebody is prone to corona, somebody is positive and he is living alone, he is isolated in his house alone. Does that mean he is not a part of society? He is living alone. Does that mean he is not a part of society? No, he is the part of society. Though you are not meeting anybody, even if you call through your phone and talk to somebody, that also means you are a part of society. And sometimes you don't call anybody, but you want some entertainment. You listen to the song which is sung by somebody. You see the dance which is danced by somebody. That also means you are a part of society. You are looking at somebody. Though you are not meeting them, but you are looking at somebody. That also means you are a part of society. That's why there is no individual without a society. An individual can't survive because you are always dependent on somebody else. Can you grow your crops by yourself for your food? Can you isolate yourself and live forever? No, you are dependent. So there is no individual without a society. Now let me ask you a question. Whether an individual can live alone on this earth? Can you live alone on this earth? No. Why? Because the human is a social animal. Human is a social animal. Students, when a child is born, especially for first 2-3 years, the child is completely dependent on the parents even to walk and even to talk. Isn't it? It can't completely explain what it wants. Compared to animals, human growth rate is very slow. To completely grow into a human being, complete growth, a body, that is a human, needs 15 years a human needs to completely grow. And one more thing, from the prehistoric period till now, whatever the changes has happened in the human beings, it is because of the interaction. By looking at others and by encountering some situations,
the human is learning. In case the human was alone, an individual, could he learn? No, he couldn't. So the main reason for the development is looking at others, learning, interaction and everything. That's why human is a social animal. Now let's learn the meaning of sociology. Sociology word is derived by two words. One is Latin, one more is Greek. Let's learn now. Socius. First word is socius, which is a Latin word which means companion. It might be your family, your neighbor, your friends, your best friends, anything. Okay, socius is a Latin word which means companion. And next word, that is logos. Logos is a Greek word which means science or study about it. Students, now you know sociology is the science or the study of human society, isn't it? Now let's learn about the scope of sociology. What are the uses of sociology? How is it useful for us? How does it work? What does it study about? Everything we will learn now. Scope of sociology. Sociology studies about the human social life. The human social life. That means the, how humans are interacting with the people who are living in the society. What is their behavior? How do they communicate? What is the behavior? This sociology observes and studies about it. How is their behavior daily? Today you are talking to somebody, doesn't mean tomorrow also you will talk to that person. There is changes in the pattern. So sociology observes regarding that and studies about human social life. Next, about social relationships. That means sociology studies about social relationships. It might be relationship with your family, your mother, father, brother, sister, uncle, aunt, grandmother, grandfather, cousins, great-grandmother, great-grandfather, everybody. And social relationship means it is not only about family, but also the your close neighbors. Sometimes you'll be very close to your neighbor, your friends, and different people where you come together. Sociology studies about social relationships. Next, about social institution. Sociology also studies about the social institution. It might be educational institution, religious institution, family, where people come together for some cause. In educational institution, they come together for educational cause. Where in a religious institution, they come together for some religious cause. And even about the social processes, sociology studies about. Now let's study about the nature of sociology. Nature means it's a feature or characteristics of sociology. That is the first point. Sociology has a unique place among all the social sciences. Sociology stands separate or different when it's compared to other social sciences. Maybe it's history, political science, geography and different social sciences. And it is also considered as a separate field of study. It is considered as the separate field of study. Now let's learn about the nature or feature of sociology. Sociology is a social science and not a physical science. What does that mean? Sociology is a more related to social sciences. Studies social life and activities of the people. What does it do? It observes the social life of a human being and studies about it. It is about the social science and not the physical science. Means in physics or chemistry, you'll have some specific formula. In chemistry especially, you'll have some chemical formula where you have to stick to that. You have to engage with that formula. Only then you'll get good result. What you are expecting, that result you will get. But in sociology, it depends on the social life and activities of the people. It observes about the people. For example, a dog is chasing a human being. A dog is chasing a human being. What will a human do? He will run after his life. One option. He will scare the dog away. He will just throw a stone to a dog where it will get scared and it will run away. Point number two. What happens? Daily if the dog comes, dog chases the human being, will the human get scared every day? He will find one or the other way. Sociology observes about the human behavior. Where first day a human being have got scared because of the dog. Next day he might be confident enough. So there is changes in the the behavior. Understand? So sociology studies about the social life and activities of people. It has a close relationship with other social sciences. Sociology has close relationship or interrelation with other social sciences. It might be history, political science, civics, geography, and other social sciences. It is very close related. Second nature or the feature of sociology is, sociology is definitive study but not a directive study. What does that mean? Let's learn now. It studies about human society as it is. Sociology doesn't go to change the perspective regarding or the view regarding the society. However, it studies like that. It doesn't go to make any changes regarding the society. Then, it never engages in how it should be studied. What does that mean? There is no a specific way to study it. My perspective is different, your perspective might be different. Like how you have in maths, A plus B whole square. This is the formula you have to use to find some answers. In sociology, you don't have that way. Your perspective is different, my perspective is different. And for an example, for me, a dog might be chasing a human. You might see that and feel that that man has taken this dog for a job. So your perspective is different, my perspective is different, where it never engages in how it should be studied. Next point, it does not engage in value judgments. In some religions where human sacrifices animal, where in some religions they sacrifice a hen, where some religions they don't sacrifice anything, they just do some rituals, where they just do some puja. Okay, that doesn't mean here I will judge which religion is good or bad. No, in sociology, they don't do any value judgments. They don't do any value judgments. They just observe. They just observe where these people are sacrificing an animal. They don't do any value judgment, that is, it is good or bad, it is right or wrong. Such thing doesn't come here, where it does not engage in any value judgments. Third feature. Sociology is a pure science and not an applied science. Applied science means it is not dependent on some formula or it is not dependent on some experiment and its results. Only that they have to stick to. No. This is a pure science where it is more related to observation. It observes and then it studies about it, about the situation. Next point. Now let's learn the fourth feature or nature of sociology. Sociology is an intangible science and not a tangible science. For example, you will find different battles in history, isn't it? Sociology is not interested in all that battles, but after every battle, what are the changes which has brought in human life? It studies about the pattern. Sociology studies about the pattern, that is, it considered these pattern and forms of social conflict and subjects them to a scientific study. Like because of such specific battles, what are the changes which has brought in human life? It sociology studies about it. Next one, that is, sociology is a general science and not a special science. Sociology studies the general interaction of the people involving that is human beings like religion, politics, moral and intellectual aspects. Sociology studies about all these aspects, where other social sciences, what happens about politics, political science, it studies about politics, then about economic studies, all this moral, the intellectual aspects, separate social science you have. But sociology studies about all these aspects at once and it has a wider scope or wider users. It studies about wider concept. Importance of sociology. Now let's learn about how is sociology important. What are the importance of sociology? Sociology studies the human society scientifically. That means sociology studies about the human society, the society in which a human lives in. Second one, supplements the personality development. Like how you have few classes regarding your personality development, where you learn to develop your personality, maybe confidence, your behavior and everything. Human being is as a social being. As a social being means because he lives in the society, is expected to adjust to the nature of the society. Like live example you have it now. How was was your pattern? How was your behavioral pattern before? Early morning, you used to wake up, you used to get ready for the school, come, study. By 2 o'clock, you used to finish your work, go home, have lunch, do your homework, then play, then have your lunch, dinner, sleep. This was your pattern. Now, because of a situation where you have to adjust, and our pattern is changed now. We will be recording the classes, sending it to you where you learn it at home. You don't get ready for the school. So the human, that is, as he is a social being, you get ready, you come with your friends, isn't it, to the school. Do you come alone without anybody from your house till here? No, you are a social being where you have to indulge with everyone. So being a social being is often expected to adjust to the nature of the society. Now what has happened because of this changes in the nature of the society, because of the spread of this pandemic, this corona, you have to change your pattern of life. So you are, being a social being, you are expected to adjust with the nature of the society. Next, facilitates the holistic personality development, that is complete personality development, by creating a holistic understanding of social structure, changes and individual responsibility. What is your responsibility now? To wear a mask, have safe distance, about all this sociology studies. Next, understanding the social processes, helps in understanding the social processes by studying their religion, tradition, culture, social rules and regulation, and values of various societies. The values of various societies keep changing. It is not one and the same, but it can't change about it. It has to accept the human values or the values of the society as it is. It studies about the religion of that particular society, tradition, culture, social rules and regulation, and understands it and then studies it. Next, aids means helps in understanding social problems and their solution. What are the social problems you have? Recently you might find in the news channels where your celebrities whom you believe they are your heroes, heroines, you were influenced by them, the way they dress, their behaviors, the way they walk. Now what has happened? You find them indulge in drugs, which is a social problem. So let's learn about the social problem. The crime, these are also crime. The murders, the rape and everything. Juvenile crime. Juvenile means the crime, the person who takes, that person is under 18. Juvenile crime. Communal clashes, religious communal clashes, which you find in news these days. Alcoholism, the ones who drinks. Caste-based discrimination, unemployment, child labor, etc. These are the social problems which we find in our society. So sociology helps us understand these problems and find good solutions to combat or to come over these problems which we find in society. Students, as I told you, social sciences and sociology are interrelated. The social sciences have different parts, isn't it? It might be history, political science, economics, and different parts which is interrelated with sociology. Sociology is a separate field of study now, where these social sciences are interrelated with it. Let's learn about it. So the relationship between sociology and political science. What is political science? What does the political science study about? We have learned about this. Political science studies about the interaction between the political institution. Political science studies about the interaction between the political institution. And here, sociology studies about the various institutions like social groups within the political institution, or the political structure, the groups which come within political institution, the sociology studies about it. Next one, relationship between sociology and history. What is history? History and sociology are interrelated. But what is history? As you know, history is the study of the past events. History is the study of whatever has happened in the past. Your sociology helps the history or the historians to, by providing scientific knowledge of various social institutions and their roles. What does sociology helps history with, historians with? the people who lived during those days, about their behavioral pattern and how did it change gradually, about all this general information or the scientific knowledge is been given by sociologists to the historians. This is how sociology helps history, or how it is interrelated. Next one, relationship between sociology and anthropology. But what is anthropology? Students, the culture and social part of human and its history. The culture and social part of humans and its history is studied by anthropology. And sociology studies about the complete human life. Sociology studies about the complete human life. A part of human life, that is culture and social part, is studied by the anthropology. Next one. Relationship between sociology and psychology. What is psychology? Psychology studies the behavioral aspect of human beings from the psychological perspective. By psychological perspective, or what are the mental perspective? What are the other person's views? How is he behaving? All that things are studied by the psychology. Sociology seeks to study the social behavior. How is that person behaving in the society? And social interaction, how is he interacting with other people who are living in the society and its functions? How is he functioning? All that things is studied by the sociology. Here psychology studies the behavioral aspect of one person, but here sociology seeks the study of social behavior, his pattern, how is he behaving in the society and his social interactions. Next, relationship between sociology and economics. What is economics? As you all know, economics studies the economic activity of a human being, by the production, consumption, distribution and exchange of goods and services. And what does sociology seek? Sociology seeks to understand interaction between the economic activities and the social activity. Here it also studies how the human behavior forms the economic activity. And while analyzing the human behavior, sociology studies other social sciences in its own way.